Hello. I thought I heard someone. Excuse me, I should introduce myself. I am Timothy Wright, and you are?
Jonathan.
Jonathan, it's a pleasure to meet you. I presume you'd like to rent out a room, yes? After all, why else would you be here?
Rent?
Oh, no need to be concerned, my friend. Your stay here is absolutely free. No charge.
Okay, is anyone else here?
No, you're the only person I've seen for a while.
How long's a while? Day, a week, months?
You know, I can't quite remember.
Look, this is going by real quick and I don't really know what's going on. I'm really confused right now. Who are you?
I believe I told you who I am. Is there something wrong?
You're the first person I've met in I don't even know how long. And it's like you don't even know what's going on.
I get the sense that you're tired. Perhaps it would be best if you were to go downstairs and rest a while.
Fine. Sorry.
Don't worry about it. Just get some rest now. I presume you're wondering what this is, yes?
Oh yeah, I guess.
Well, it is a portrait of an ancient entity known as the Varin.
I've never heard of it.
Oh, well, the Varin is not something to be taken lightly. It is regarded by those who follow it as the pathway to the unnatural. Its power is incomprehensible by that of a human.
Oh, that's interesting.
Indeed. I apologize, Jonathan. I got off track. You can go rest now. Oh, Jonathan? Please don't go into the basement, or the bathroom down there. Please.
Okay. Yeah.
So, Jonathan, tell me about yourself.
I don't know what to say.
Come on, what are you like? What are your ambitions?
Like, my life story?
Yes.
Well, I grew up in Gary, Indiana, with my parents and brother. After high school, I wanted to go to college to be an electrical engineer. Until this happened. Now all I want to do is find my brother and the rest of my family, if they're even still out there.
I'm sorry, Jonathan.
Thanks.
You'll find your family, I'm sure of it. Then, hey, afterwards, maybe you can head off to college, become an electrical engineer.
Right. What about you?
What about me?
Well, I've slept in your home overnight now. I don't even know anything about you. Tell me about yourself.
Well, I don't remember much of my younger days, but either way, I thought it doesn't really matter. Ever since I bought and refurbished this house, I feel like I've never been better.
Why?
Jonathan, I've never told this to anyone before, but I was lucky enough to receive a large sum of money.
You inherited money?
Yes, but to this day, the donut is still a mystery. How or why anyone would send me so much money is beyond my understanding.
How much did you receive?
I'm afraid I can't say. Strictly confidential.
You mentioned that you've never been better. Has money played a role in that?
Indeed, Jonathan. Money has played a very important role in my well-being. You see, Jonathan, I never dreamed of going to college, or finding a degree, or living even a normal life. I've always wanted to be a part of the upper class. I wanted to be rich. I dreamed of being a part of the aristocracy. Living the easy life with nothing to worry about. Except myself, of course.
You ever wish you could turn back time? Back when the world was normal?
Normal is a human construct, Jonathan. You should know that there is no such thing as normal. But to answer your question, yes. On occasion, I wish I'd spent my money differently. More sparingly, perhaps. But these are minor regrets. I believe I have enough to get me through the rest of my life. Do you have any hobbies, Jonathan?
Hobbies?
Yes, hobbies.
No, I don't.
Oh, come on, there must be something you like. What's your favorite sport?
Baseball.
Ah, yes. Baseball is my favorite, too. What's your favorite movie?
The Shining.
Favorite band?
What's wrong with you?
I beg your pardon?
I don't know. Maybe it's the fact that you've been asking me what my favorite hobbies are, because I haven't been making it painfully obvious that I've been spending the last few weeks trudging through this godforsaken land.
Well, I'm sorry. It's just a simple question.
That's my next point. You talk like everything is fine. It's like nothing's wrong. Guess what? Nothing is right. The world will never be the same. Do you not understand that?
No.
Have you seen outside?
The world is dead. Society's dead. All my friends are dead. And here we are, in his house, eating sandwiches and talking about our favorite music.
Well, wait, where are you headed?
Going downstairs. To rest.
Well, it's just a simple question. Can I at least get an answer?
Deep purple.
I want to apologize for the minute. It's just sad.
Last time I came here, you said you hadn't seen anyone here for months.
Well, yes, I suppose.
What's this?
I'm not sure.
One more time, where is he?
I don't know. Jonathan. Please.
Start giving me that crap about why I shouldn't do this!
John.
And you're still trying to convince me that you have no idea what's going on! Idiot!
Do you honestly believe I am so oblivious to my own self-worth that I don't even know what's going on? Well, let me tell you something. I know. I know what's going on. I know about the death, the suffering, the event, all of it! Realize, Jonathan, I was only trying to help you. I was trying to ease your mind. I knew right when you set foot in this house. You've been out there for far too long. I was only trying to help you. Trying to make you feel as if the world is normal again. Realize this, Jonathan. If you kill me, you'll only be killing yourself. Think about it. How many people have you seen on your journey? Because I recall you saying that you saw no one. Not a single soul. And how long has it been? Days? Weeks? Months? We might be the only ones left. The real question is, are you willing to take the risk? I need a drink. Ah, yes. Jonathan. Please, take a seat.
Yeah. I want to apologize. I got carried away. I shouldn't have done that to you.
Jonathan. It's all right. I understand what you're going through. It's tough.
I know you said that we might be the last people left alive, but I'm not gonna give up. Tomorrow, I'm going back out there to search for survivors. I think it's important that we have hope.
I do not believe you'll find anyone, but I respect your decision, Jonathan.
I mean, there's gotta be someone out there, right? I mean, after all, I ended up finding you, right?
But after how long?
All I'm saying is that there's still hope for finding other survivors.
Perhaps it's time I told you the story of the Varin. The Varin is a mysterious but powerful entity. So powerful, in fact, it can mimic anything it sees and become virtually indistinguishable.
How's that?
It can blend in with its surroundings. Of course, it does this to lure its victims.
So it tricks people?
Yes. Those who follow the Varin believe that it is looking for an apprentice. One that would follow its ways and eventually take its place. The Varin would mimic something close to the victim, or someone close to the victim, in order to get closer to them. Once the victim is subdued, the Varin decides whether or not they would fit the role of apprentice. And if they don't fit the role, well, the Varin simply kills them. It's frightening, really, knowing that nowhere is truly safe. That it might be watching your every move.
It's not real. It's just a story, right?